Hi, I'm Dr. Madhu Goel, Director of Obstetrics and Gynecology at Fortis La Femme, Greater Kailash, Part 2.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mudit Sabharwa, Senior Consultant, Diabetes and Endocrinology at Fortis La Femme, Greater Kailash, Part 2.
So today we are going to talk about gestational diabetes. Gestational diabetes is where you develop high blood sugar, which is detected for the first time in pregnancy after 20 weeks of pregnancy.
Well, it happens in females in pregnancy because of two major reasons. One is when the pancreatic beta cells are not functioning well, which dysregulates the glucose homeostasis, leading to hyperglycemia, that means uncontrolled blood glucose levels during pregnancy. So it happens in pregnancy due to two reasons. One is when the pancreatic beta cell functions is not normal, which leads to irregulation of glucose homeostasis, leading to hyperglycemia, that means uncontrolled blood glucose levels. Secondly, it's because of the pregnancy hormones, which includes growth hormone, prolactin, etc., which leads to increase in insulin resistance, and hence, again, uncontrolled blood glucose levels during pregnancy.
So it is important that you know whether you have diabetes in pregnancy, as gestational diabetes is associated with complications both for the baby and the mother. The baby can have a larger weight than a normal baby, and once the baby is more in weight, it can result in an operative delivery in terms of a cesarean section, or if you are having a normal delivery, it can result in trauma to the genital areas. The baby can be born before time, that means it can be a preterm baby. These babies are also at a higher risk for respiratory distress syndrome or breathing issues, and these babies are also at a higher risk for developing diabetes later on in pregnancy. For the mother as well, gestational diabetes can be associated with high blood pressure. It can be associated with a condition which we call preeclampsia, which can make the pregnancy at a much higher risk, and it is associated with more close monitoring.
Well, there are various risk factors for developing gestational diabetes. Of course, if you have a family history of type 2 diabetes, you were obese, you had polycystic ovarian syndrome or polycystic ovarian disorder, or else you had a previous pregnancy where the baby was born with a weight more than gestational age, or macrosomia. So these are certain common, and of course, if you're a smoker, that basically doubles your risk to develop gestational diabetes.
So irrespective of the risk factors, all pregnant women should be screened for diabetes.
As mentioned before, they should be screened after 20 weeks of pregnancy for gestational diabetes.
And the screening for diabetes can be earlier if you are a known pre-diabetic or if you have multiple high-risk factors.
Hence, managing diabetes becomes very critical. There are three parts of managing diabetes for getting better results. One is, of course, glucose monitoring and tracking. The more we can monitor, the more we can track, the better results we can achieve. There are two ways to monitor. One is, of course, the conventional self-monitoring of blood glucose levels, the seven-pointer technique, or it's the continuous glucose monitoring, which we usually use nowadays to get better results. Secondly, in management, there are two parts. One is, of course, the diet and lifestyle. Diet may include medical nutritional therapy, where the diet of the female is individualized as per her routine, her lifestyle, and of course the requirements in her pregnancy. Carbohydrates be required to cut down to about 30-35%, and of course the proteins may be increased in her overall diet. The female is definitely advised to walk regularly, at least 20-30 minutes of walk during pregnancy, but she should not be pushed to over and above her limit in walking. Should be comfortable. And secondly, it's the pharmacological management, which includes oral hypoglycemics like metformin and including various insulin regimes.
So not only managing your blood sugar, but your pregnancy management also changes. Your pregnancy becomes a high-risk pregnancy. You need more frequent visits to a gynecologist. You need perhaps more ultrasounds to see whether your baby is doing well. Your delivery will be timed according to your gestation and baby weight as decided by your gynecologist. So you should decide to deliver at a place which has good nursery facilities and where the obstetrician is trained to manage such cases.
Well, not only during the pregnancy and just at the delivery, post-delivery also, you should see your doctor at least after within 6 weeks or after 6 weeks of delivery. to prevent or to screen for and then to prevent any possible complications. And after that also, the patients are advised to see their doctors at least 6 months to every 6 months to 3 years in order to screen for any hyperglycemia and control blood glucose levels and then any possible complications due to gestational diabetes.